By early August 2006, investigators are watching and listening. MI5, the British Secret Service, are recording Ali and his co-conspirators' every move. Operation Overt becomes the biggest surveillance operation of its kind in Great Britain. At one point, British law enforcement have 1,000 intelligence police officers, including surveillance teams, deployed to keep tabs on Ali, Sarwar, and other core members of the group. They watch as meetings take place in restaurants and parks. Surveillance also reveals something much more sinister: the construction of incredibly sophisticated explosive devices. Operatives inside the apartment are observed constructing something out of drink bottles.
They were able to observe Ali drill holes into the soft drinks, the bottom of the soft drinks, to extract the ingredients. And then they used the syringes to inject hydrogen peroxide mixed with tang into the bottle.
Surveillance teams watching the apartment soon discover the purpose for the batteries and other contents airport security had secretly found in Ali's suitcase. They watch as Ali and Sarwar conceal the chemical compound hexamethylene triperoxide diamine, HMTD, inside hollow Toshiba AA batteries. Black foam is used to conceal the hole at the bottom of the batteries. They then work on what investigators believe is the trigger for the explosives.
They were going to use a disposable camera, the flash on a disposable camera, to trigger the explosion. So they were very concerned.
Through the cameras hidden in Ali's apartment, the surveillance team observed two plotters design what appears to be the schematics for a liquid bomb. Ali is overheard talking about a big boom and getting their virgins. He then begins to count a total of 18 recruits for the attack. The attack is a suicide operation.
So, I mean, one thing is to having people who sympathize with your ideology, and another thing is to go beyond that and agree to participate in suicide missions, which is what this was. So these are hardcore people.